Dear friends, in previous video we have discussed about pre-experimental design. Now we'll discuss about true experimental design. Before starting for that, we recall the types of experimental design, and those are as shown on the screen. Number one, pre-experimental design. Number two, true experimental design. Number three, quasi-experimental design. Now I'll discuss about true experimental design. We'll start with the meaning of the same. In pre-experimental design, all the extraneous moderator and compound variables are controlled with a view to check the clear and precise impact of independent variable on dependent variable. But in education psychology and social sciences, all the extraneous compounding and moderator variable cannot be controlled completely. So, maximum efforts are made to control all such variables. If maximum efforts are made for controlling such variables, then that will be known as true experimental design in terms of education, psychology and social sciences. Now we'll see the types of true experimental design. Number one is two randomized groups post-test only. Number two, two randomized groups matching pair, matched pair, pairs post-test only. Number three, two equivalent groups pre-test, post-test only. Number three, Solomon randomized four groups design. And number fifth is factorial design. Now let us start with two randomized groups post-test only design. Friends, as reflected from the name of this design, in this design, first of all, the subjects are selected from the population randomly for the sample, and after that selection, the subjects are divided into two groups randomly. In this way, two groups are made, then manipulation of independent variable is done, experiment is conducted. After completion of the experiment, test of the subjects of both the groups is taken in terms of dependent variable, and after obtaining the scores of both the groups, the scores are compared to come to the conclusion regarding the impact of independent variable on dependent variable. This design is presented symbolically as shown on the screen. Let us see on the screen. ERXT2CR-T2, where ER means an experimental group containing randomly distributed subjects. X is treatment independent variable. T2 is post-test. CR is control group containing randomly distributed subjects. This is a true experimental design, and in this design, maximum efforts are made to maintain the validity of experiment. Let us see the benefits of two randomized groups only post-test design. Here, effect of extraneous variables is balanced and controlled because two groups are there. If extraneous variables are not controlled, then such variables will affect both the groups equally. So their effect will be balanced, effect will be zero. In this way, the validity internal validity of the experiment will be maintained. Number two, effect of interaction between the extraneous variable and the test on dependent variable is eliminated. Here no pretest is there, so the subjects will not be matured in terms of the experiment or in terms of the dependent variable. So there will be no interaction effect of extraneous variable, and the test will be there on dependent variable. That is the major benefit of this design. As discussed earlier, the effect of maturity can be avoided because the subjects will not be given any pretest, so they will not know anything about the experiment or independent variable before conduction of the experiment, so maturity problem will not be there. This design is flexible in terms of number of groups. It means if it is required, the experimenter can make more than two groups for conducting experiment, and all the groups will be given different treatments. The impact of different treatments will be compared with one another, and better treatment can be judged in terms of the impact on dependent variable. In this way, this design is flexible. If the effect of treatment is to be judged on the basis of observation only, this design will be the most convenient. If no test is to be taken only, the subjects are to be observed to know the impact of independent variable, then this design is very much convenient. And now let us see the limitation of two randomized groups only post-test design. The major limitation of this design is subjects are selected randomly in this design. For that, first of all, a group of subjects from the population is selected randomly. Then the selected group is divided into groups randomly, and for that a list of all the subjects of population has to be prepared, and it cannot be done in all situations, especially when the population has been very large. If large population is there, if the subjects are spread on the larger area, then making the list of all the subjects will be tedious. In that way, this design is not convenient for selecting the subjects randomly. If subjects are scattered in a large geographical area that I have discussed earlier, the task of gathering them at the one place becomes impossible and impractical, because we have to conduct the experiment, and if the subjects are scattered on large in a large geographical area, then we have to gather them at one place, and it will be difficult to gather them at one place. So in that sense, this design cannot be used for conducting experimental research. Now we'll see another true experimental design, that is two randomized groups matching pair only post-test design. Friends, as reflected from its name, here also two randomized groups are taken, but the groups are made on the matching pair basis. What does it mean? Matching pair, matched pair means what? Only post-test design is only post-test is used in this design. But we must know what is matching pair. Friends, here, first of all, the subjects for the sample are selected randomly from the population. Then, before conducting the experiment, all the subjects are given a taste based on moderator variable. See, taste is taken on the that is based on moderator variable. Moderator variable means the variable that may affect the cause and effect relationship between independent dependent variable. So researcher has to find such moderator variable, and he has to take the taste of the subjects on the basis of moderator variable, and such a moderator variable is selected that has the good correlation with dependent variable on the basis of the taste scores obtained by conducting the test based on moderator variable. All the subjects are arranged according to their scores in that test. Subjects are arranged in descending order. Then, as shown on the screen, here for making the pairs, matching pairs. One example is given here. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, 9 subjects are there. They are selected randomly. Their taste based on the moderator variable is taken. Their scores are obtained here. And they are arranged in descending order of the scores obtained by them from 55 to 39. After arranging the subjects in this way, one by one, the subjects are placed in two different groups. How? Let us see. First subject is has obtained here 55 marks in the test based on moderator variable. So first subject is placed randomly in group 1. Then another subject that has obtained 54 marks is placed in another group. Then third subject that has obtained 53 marks is placed in group 2. Fourth subject that has obtained 50 marks is placed in group 1. E, the subject E that has obtained 48 marks is placed in group 1 again. F, who has obtained 48 marks, is placed in group 2. G has obtained 47 marks, and H has obtained 40 marks. Very big difference is there between G and H. So G is not selected here. We should remember here that the pairs of the subjects are made on the basis of the scores obtained by them, and in each pair both the subjects must have the equal scores or nearly equal scores. What does nearly equal scores mean? It is said that if there is the difference of 2 or 3 marks between two subjects, then they are called nearly equal. If the difference between the scores of two subjects is more than 3 marks, then they are not considered the nearly equal scores. So if the difference is big between two subjects, then subjects are ignored and they are not placed in the group. So here the subject G, that is G, was obtained 47 and H was obtained 40. The difference of 7 marks is there, so G is not placed in any group. H has obtained 40, so it is placed In group 2, I has obtained 39 marks, so it is placed in group 1. In this way, the pairs of subjects are made by comparing their scores in the test that is based on moderator variable. That's why this is known as matching pair design. And two randomized groups are taken here. This design is presented symbolically as shown on the screen. PR X T2, then matched pair is written, then CR dash T2, where PR equals to an experimental group containing randomly distributed subjects from matched pair. From each pair, the subjects are distributed randomly in different groups. X is treatment. T2 is post-test. CR is a controlled group containing randomly distributed subjects from matched pair. And in symbolic presentation, between the two lines, first and third line, matched pair is to be written. Now, see the benefits of randomized groups, matching pair only post-test design. Before proceeding for that, we should know that after making the pairs of the subjects based on the scores obtained by the subjects in the test that is based on the moderator variable, two groups are made. One group is given treatment. Another group is either not given treatment or such a treatment is given that has no impact on dependent variable. Then, after completion of this task, the post-test in terms of dependent variable is taken and the scores of both the groups are compared to come to the conclusion regarding the impact of independent variable on dependent variable. Some benefits of this design are shown on the screen. Number one, it is very convenient in making the groups with less number of subjects. If subjects are less, then this is very convenient design of two experimental designs. Pairs can be made on the basis of two or more such variables that have significant correlation with dependent variable of study. We have seen the example in which the pairs are made on the basis of the test that is based on one moderator variable. But if the experimenter wants to be more precise in terms of the experiment, in terms of the making groups, in terms of making the groups, then instead of considering only one moderator variable, you can consider two or more moderator variables to divide the subjects in different groups on the basis of the scores of two or more moderator variables based test. The subjects are divided in two or more groups. This design is very effective in maintaining the external validity of the experiment, as both the groups become homogeneous in terms of the particular variable characteristics. So the clear impact of independent variable on dependent variable can be measured because both the groups will become homogeneous because they are divided on the basis of the scores obtained by the subjects in the test based on moderator variable. So both the groups will become equivalent in terms of that moderator variable. So the experimental external validity of the experiment will be maintained. Some limitations of two randomized groups are also there. Two randomized matching pair only post-test design. limitations are like shown on the screen. The task of selecting such a variable that has significant and good positive correlation with dependent variable needs good insight and understanding about the area of research. If the experimenter has enough experience in the area of research, then only he can decide the proper moderator variable for dividing the subjects into groups on matching pair basis. Or else he has no experience about the area of research, then he has to conduct the test. He has to find the moderator variable on the basis of the correlation of different moderator variables with dependent variables, and in that exercise the time will be consumed more. So in this way, the task of selecting such a variable that has significant and good positive correlation with dependent variable needs good insight. Now another design of two experimental is two randomized groups, pre-test, post-test design. Friends, as reflected from its name, in this design also, two groups of the subjects are selected. For that, first of all, subjects are selected randomly from the population according to the required size of the sample in both the groups. Then all the selected subjects are divided into groups randomly. After dividing the subjects into groups, pre-test of both the groups is taken in terms of dependent variable. Then one group is given treatment, another group is either not given treatment or given such a treatment that is no impact on dependent variable. In this way, experiment is conducted. After completion of the experiment, post-test is administered. Scores of the subjects of both the groups are obtained in post-test. Then, by comparing the scores of the subjects in pre-test and post-test, decision regarding the impact of independent variable on dependent variable is taken. Symbolically, this design is presented as shown on the screen. TR, T1, X, T2, CR, T1, dash T2, where ER is an experimental group containing randomly selected subjects. X is treatment, that is independent variable. T1 is pre-test. T2 is post-test. CR is a controlled group containing randomly selected subjects. Friends, here pre and post both tests are taken. So we have to be very much careful while comparing the scores. Different methods are there. One method is the gain scores of both the groups are obtained. Gain scores means T2 minus T1 means the scores of post-test. From the scores of post-test, the scores of pre-test of each subject is subtracted means T2 minus T1 is a gain score. In this way, gain score of both the groups are obtained, and by comparing the gain scores, the decision regarding the clear and precise impact of independent variable on dependent variable is taken. Some other methods are also there for comparing the scores, but we will not discuss here about that. Now we will see the benefits of two randomized groups, pre-test, post-test design, as shown on the screen. Both the groups become equivalent to a great extent because at first stage the subjects are selected randomly from the population, then all the subjects are divided in two groups randomly. In that sense, both the groups become equivalent to a great extent because the subjects having different level of characteristics in terms of dependent variable are distributed equally in most of the cases in two groups, so they will become equivalent to a great extent. The researcher will have an opportunity of controlling the subjects as he uses pre-test also. If the experimenter wants to use the pre-test scores to equalize the groups, then he can do here because pre-test is taken here. On the basis of pre-test, the experimenter can compare the scores of the subjects. If no significant difference is found between the mean scores of the subjects of both the groups in pre-test, then you can take the decision that both the groups are equivalent in terms of the order variable. So here the researcher will have an opportunity of controlling the subjects as he uses pre-test also, and in another sense also that a pre-test is taken here, and if the gain scores are used for analyzing the data, then so many extraneous variables and moderator variables can be controlled. Now let us see another benefit of this design. As I have discussed, many external variables can be controlled in this design because all the extraneous or compounding or moderator variable will affect at the same level both the groups, so their effect will be balanced and their effect will be nullified because both the groups will be affected by such variables equally. So internal validity of experiment can be maintained in this design. One more benefit, this design provides an opportunity of using ANCOVA. ANCOVA means analysis of covariance. This is the best method of data analysis, that is parametric test. ANCOVA is here. The pre-test course can be taken as covariate, and by using this course as covariate, ANCOVA can be used for analyzing the data. Let us now see the limitations of two randomized groups pre-test post-test design as shown on the screen. First limitation is due to interactive effect of treatment and pre-test, the external validity of the experiment is imperiled. Here pre-test is taken, so the subjects of both the groups will become conscious and aware of the treatment, so they will show anxiety in the during the experiment, and they will give better response to the experiment. They will give better. They will concentrate more in the experiment. So the treatment will affect much more than the expected level. This is called interactive effect of treatment and pretest. That may happen here in this design because pretest is used here. Interaction between treatment and history and contemporary events may affect the external validity of the experiment. History and contemporary events, if the experiment is conducted and is being conducted and some unexpected events occur, unexpected situation will occur, then that may affect the subjects, that may make the subjects more conscious or less conscious, and such unexpected events may be the pandemic or natural disaster or riots or any natural calamity will be there during the experiment. Then adverse effect will be there on the subjects in terms of dependent variable, in terms of the treatment. And if such situation will be there, then the findings obtained by the experiment cannot be generalized on the larger population, because same types of the events will not be there in the future whenever this experiment will be conducted. In that sense, the external validity of the experiment is affected. EFT effect of treatment cannot be avoided. EFT effect is because one group is given treatment, another group is not given treatment. So the group that is given treatment, the subject of that group will be more conscious and anxious in terms of the treatment. So they will react the treatment more than the expected level. So they will respond in the post-test in a better way. So the clear impact of independent variable or dependent variable cannot be measured. Another limitation is experimental effect can also be not avoided. If both the groups are given treatment by different experimenter, then their effect cannot be avoided here. This can be limitized by giving the treatment to both the groups by the same experimenter. These are the major limitations of randomized groups pre-test post-test design. One more is that many situational variables cannot be controlled. Here groups are made equivalent because groups are divided, subjects are divided into groups randomly. But so many situational variables, extraneous variables are not controlled here. No efforts are made because the groups are selected randomly. So the internal validity may be affected by such variables. That is the major drawback of this design. Now let us see Solomon 4 group design. Friends, this design was first given by Richard Solomon. He was the British psychologist, as shown in, as reflected from the name of this design. Four groups are selected here randomly. Two groups are given pretest and two groups are not given pretest. All the groups are given post-test. Out of the two groups which are given pre-test, one group is considered as experimental group and another group is considered as control group. In the same way, out of the two groups which are not given pretest, one group is considered as an experimental group and another group is considered as control group. In this way, in this design, two experimental group will be there and two control group will be there. Let us see how this design is presented symbolically. As shown on the screen, this design is presented symbolically in this way. ER1, T1, X, T2. CR1, T1 dash T2. Then ER2 dash X, T2. CR2 dash dash T2. ER1 means first experimental group containing randomly selected subjects which are given both the test, pre-test and post-test. Pre-test is given before conducting the experiment. Post-test is given after conduction of the experiment. Then ER2 means second experimental group containing randomly selected subjects. As shown on the screen, ER2 means second experimental group will not be given pre-test. They are given the same treatment as will be given to ER1. ER2 will be given post-test only after conduction of the experiment. Then CR1. CR1 is first control group containing randomly selected subjects, CR1. This group is given pre-test. No treatment is given to this group, or such a treatment is given that has no impact on dependent variable. Then post-test of this group is taken. Then CR2. CR2 means second control group containing randomly selected subjects. Pre-test of this group is not taken. This group is not given any treatment. Post-test of this group is taken. In this way, the experimenter has four groups here, two experimental groups and two control groups. Some researchers say that only one group should be considered as experimental group, that is ER1, and all remaining groups should be considered as control group. There is difference of opinion among the researchers in terms of this randomized Solomon four groups design. Here X is treatment, two groups are given treatment. T1 is pre-test and T2 is post-test. This group is considered better than the previous three discussed, we have discussed today, better than that, those all the designs. Let us see the benefits of this design. Here, experimental and control groups are given treatment with and without pre-test. So, the effect of interaction between the test and treatment can be checked clearly because two groups are given pre-test. So, interaction effect of pre-test will be checked on both experimental and as well as on control group. So, more clearer comparison between between experimental and control group can be done. If significant difference between the results of both the experimental groups is not found, in here two groups are there, experimental group or two experimental groups are there, and one group is given pre-test and post-test both, and another experimental group is not given pre-test. And In such a case, if no significant difference between the scores of both the experimental groups in post-test is found, no significant difference is found, then researcher can confidently say that the effect that is seen on dependent variable is due to only treatment and no any other factor is responsible for it. So, clear, precise and clear decision regarding the impact of independent variable on dependent variable can be taken here by comparing the scores of two experimental groups. Limitations of Solomon 4 groups design are shown on the screen. The first one is the researcher has to be very conscious and precise for selecting four groups, because four groups are to be made, so the researcher has to be very much careful while dividing the subjects in different groups. So typical statistical techniques or the selection of technique of random selection is to be applied here. So researcher has to be very conscious and precise. Another limitation, more subjects are to be selected than other designs because they are to be divided in four groups. This is the major, more subjects are to be selected. If two groups are there, then with less number of subjects we can make the groups, but here four groups are to be made, so required number of the subjects will be more here. This is more time consuming and expensive than any other experimental design because twice the experiment is to be conducted, four groups are to be taken care of, the scores of four the all the groups are to be compared with one another, so it is time consuming. Complex statistical technique has to be used for data analysis in this design because the scores of four groups are to be compared with one another, so complex analysis has to be done here. Unexperienced and new researchers cannot justify it properly. He has to take the help of some experts for analyzing the data. This is the major limitation of this design. Very special situation has to be created for experiment in this design because twice the experiment is to be conducted and two experimental groups are there, so all the situations are controlled situation is to be made during all this experiment. So the work of controlling the situation will be tedious here in this design. Now you see the factorial design. In this design, moderator variables are taken care in during the experiment. This design is given by Fisher. In this design, one independent variable and at least one moderator variable is taken care of during the experiment, and the impact of moderator variable is also checked on dependent variable. Along with that, the interaction effect of independent and moderator variable on dependent variable is also checked. Their independent effect of independent variable and moderator variable is also checked in this design. This design is considered better than all the design because here moderator variables are given importance during the experiment. Let us see the example of this design. Here one example is given, impact of guidance on self-concept of the subjects of secondary school. here impact of guidance on self-concept of the students of secondary school is to be checked. For that, for this design, one moderator variable is also to be selected here. First, we'll see the independent variable, that is guidance. This is independent variable, and dependent variable is self-concept, because impact of guidance on self-concept is to be checked. Here, the guidance has two level, personal guidance and group guidance. So independent variables has two levels. Here, along with the independent variable, experimenter takes one more variable as moderator variable, that is here socioeconomic status, and subjects are divided in two groups according to high SES socioeconomic status and low socioeconomic status. In this way, in this design, two levels of independent variable and two levels of moderator variable are taken care of. In this way, this design is known as 2x2 factorial design, because independent variable and moderator variable has two levels each. If this design is used, then independent impact of independent variable and moderator variable, along with interaction effect of both the variables on dependent variables, can be checked. How it can be done, let us see. If this design is used, then the subjects are divided in four groups. First of all, the subjects are divided in two groups, out of which one group will be given personal guidance and one group will be given group guidance. Guidance has two levels, so here 2 is written in 2x2 factorial design. Then again, the subjects are divided in two groups according to their socioeconomic status. In each group, the subjects are divided high in high and low SES groups. So two groups will be there for personal guidance. In the same way, two groups will be there in group guidance on the basis of socioeconomic status, that is high and low. After dividing the subjects in this way, both the groups will be given different treatments. For that, personal guidance group will be given personal guidance. While giving the treatment to this group, both the groups of high and low SES will be combined, and the entire group will be given personal guidance. In the same way, for giving group guidance, the subjects of high and low socioeconomic status will be combined, and entire group will be given group guidance. In this way, after giving the guidance to both the groups, the subjects of personal groups and the subjects of group guidance groups will be given post-test. Their scores will be obtained, and their scores will be classified in this way. The subjects of the personal guidance group will be divided in two groups. Their score will be divided in these two groups. In the same way, the scores of group guidance subjects of group guidance group will be divided in two groups according to their socioeconomic status. Then the comparison of the scores will be done, and here total 8 comparison will be there. How? Let us see. First comparison will be there, in which the scores of first group means the group which is given personal guidance, all the subjects of this group and all the subjects of another group will be compared on the basis of the scores obtained by them in the post test. That will be the first comparison. On the basis of this comparison, the decision regarding the impact of guidance on subjects will be taken. Then another comparison will be made between the subjects belonging to high SCS and low SCS. This is moderator variable SCS. So subjects are compared on the basis of SCS also. On the basis of this comparison, the decision regarding the impact of SCS on self-concept of the subjects will be taken. Then another comparison will be done between two groups of personal guidance group. The two groups will be the subjects having high SCS and subjects having low SCS. Their scores will be compared. This will be third comparison. Then fourth comparison will be there. High SCS of personal group and high SCS subjects of group guidance group. Then fifth comparison will be there between high SCS subjects, subjects belonging to high SCS and personal guidance, and subjects belonging to low SCS and group guidance. Sixth comparison will be there between the subjects having low SCS and belonging to personal guidance group, and the subjects having high SCS belonging to group guidance group. Seventh comparison will be there between the subjects or belonging to low SCS of personal guidance group and group guidance group. And last comparison will be there between the subjects having high SCS and subjects having low SCS of group guidance group. In this way, in factorial design, interaction and independent effect of independent variable and moderator variable on dependent variable can be checked. Let us see the advantage of factorial design. The main advantage is main and interactive effect of two or more independent variables on dependent variable can be checked at the same time. So the results for which two or more researches are required can be obtained only in single research. Here interaction effect and independent effect both can be checked. So in the in only one research more results can be obtained in terms of more than one independent variables. Other benefit is in the above mentioned sense, this design is less time consuming and less expensive than other two experimental designs, because in the same experiment, impact of two or more independent variables or moderator variables on dependent variables can be checked. Limitation of factorial design. In this design, the data analysis is a special technique of data analysis is to be applied like ANOVA. It is very complex. ANOVA means analysis of variance. If we want to check the interaction effect, then we have to apply this technique only, statistical technique. So the inexperienced and new researchers cannot apply this design properly. This is the major limitation. Another limitation, if number of intervening or independent variables or the moderator variables increases, the data analysis process will become more and more complex. Friends, in this way, today we have discussed about different types of true experimental design. In previous video, we have discussed about different types of pre-experimental design. Now, in next video, we will discuss about post-experimental design. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.